Today, we are going to discuss various roles performed by the manager while working in the organization. Now, as a head of the institute or as a head of the organization, manager has to play various roles. Like, sometimes he need to provide some kind of information, sometimes he need to develop certain interpersonal relationships, and sometimes he also has to take a lot of decisions. So, while performing these roles, he has to take certain actions. So, what are these roles? Let us have a look at it. Mintzberg, in the year 1971, classified manager's role under three subcategories. Those categories are: the first role performed by the manager is as a interpersonal role. Second category is informational role, and the third category is decisional role. So we can say manager has to perform these three roles according to Mintzberg, like interpersonal role, informational role, and decisional role. Under the main category of interpersonal role, again his role is divided into three subcategories. These three subcategories are as a figurehead, as a leader, and as a liaison. Now let us have a look at the role as a figurehead. Now manager is a leader, he is a figurehead of the institute. So as a figurehead, he has to play a role. While playing a role as a figurehead, he is the main of the organization and he has to represent himself as a figurehead. Just like in our family, we have a father figure, and for any kind of decisions, for taking any kind of actions, we consult that father figure. Same way, in the organization, manager has to play a role of figurehead. While performing the role of figurehead, he has to do certain kind of actions, like he is a symbolic head, he is obliged to perform number of routine duties of legal or social nature. While working in the organization, he is acting as a symbolic head. And while acting as a symbolic head, he has to perform various legal and social activities. Now, he has to take lot of decisions, he has to play a role of figurehead. While doing this, various legal issues, various social issues which may arise in the organization, that manager has to consult, that manager has to take action on it. Now, what are the various kind of activities involved when we are looking at manager as a figurehead? He has to participate in ceremony, he has to sign reports, request, and solicitations. Like when he play as a role of figurehead, he has to participate in various activities, various ceremonies. Say for example, there is an annual day program in a school, so that time HM or a principal plays a role of figurehead. He is the representative of that institute. So while performing the role as a figurehead, he has to represent that annual function. Same way, he has to do many social and legal actions in the organization. It may happen that there might arise various issues in the organization. It might be legal issues, it might be social issues. So in that particular situation, as a father figure, as a figurehead, he has to perform various roles. He has to sign reports. Many reports, one or the other day, has been prepared by the school, has been prepared by the organization, and these reports need to be signed by the manager. He has to attend the request solicitations. Many of the requests, there might be many correspondence from other organization, that also he need to sign. Various times, as a figurehead, manager has to take part in various activities. So that time he has to work as a figurehead or as a father figure. Many times various reports need to be signed by the managers. Then that time it will be a sole responsibility of the manager to sign those reports, to answer those various government resolutions which is sent from the government to the institute. That time manager has to sign those reports. Various requests sent by other organizations also need to be taken care by the manager. So we saw that manager as a figurehead has to perform various jobs, various activities he need to take into part. So when he is playing the role of manager as a figurehead, he has to do certain kind of jobs like attending the ceremony, signing the reports, and attending the request of other people. It may happen that there are requests from the parents, requests from the students, requests from the teachers that also need to be taken care by the manager as a figurehead. So we saw manager has to play a role of figurehead when we are discussing interpersonal role of the manager. Second subhead which comes under interpersonal role is as a leader. Manager also has to play a role of leader. So while playing as a role of leader, he has to lead the institute, he has to lead the organization. Now, while leading the organization, he has to motivate his staff, he has to initiate his staff for doing the work. Many a time, manager as a leader need to assign the jobs, assign the work to the members of the organization. It may happen that manager has to assign the job for the teachers, manager has to assign the job for the non-teaching staff and other members of the organization. So while doing this, he is playing a role as a leader. The leader is the one who leads or who motivates, who initiates action of the members of the organization. So while doing so, he has to do the activities like staffing, training and associated duties. He need to staff the members of the organization. Now staffing means he need to appoint a person who will be requiring for doing those particular type of work. So staffing, many times he has to control various functions of the organizations, like controlling the budget, controlling the workload, controlling the disputes which may arise among the members of the organization. So staffing, controlling, directing, planning, all are part of a manager, and while performing this task, he is working as a leader. He is the one who is leading the organization, he is the one who is initiating the members to work on different tasks, he is the one who is doing the staffing, controlling, directing and planning. So in this process, he is performing the role as a leader. Now when he is performing the role as a leader, he has to take part in various activities like directing, staffing, controlling, delegating. These are the some of the activities which he will be involved in. So we can say all managerial activities he has to perform. While performing these activities, he is playing the role as a leader. The third type of sub role which comes under interpersonal role is as a liaison. Manager many times has to keep contact with outside world. So while doing this, he is working as a liaison. He is performing a role as a liaison. Liaison means he is developing rapport, he is developing contact outside the world. It may happen that manager has to keep contact with other organization, with other schools, with other institutes, with government organizations, with other institutes which are in that particular area. So because manager job is not only restricted for himself or not only for his own organization, but he has to develop rapport with other members of the society, with the society, with other institutes. And while doing so, he is working as a liaison. He is the one who is bridging the gap between himself and the society, because school or organization cannot work in isolation. While performing, while doing the functioning of the organization, he also has to develop rapport with the society, because unless and until manager gets a cooperation, support, unless and until manager gets develop the rapport with the society, his organization may not function smoothly. So that time manager is working as a liaison. He is the one who is developing a link or who is developing the rapport with the society. So for this, he has to participate in various activities like acknowledging the mails. One or the other day, manager gets lot of correspondence with the society, lot of correspondence with the government organizations, lot of correspondence with other schools which is situated in that particular locality. So acknowledging their mail, responding their queries, all this kind of work manager has to do. That time he is performing as a role of a liaison. Many times he has to give answers to various government GRs. One or the other day, there might be some regulations, there might be some policies changes which need to be communicated to the manager, and manager needs to give feedback, give response to these correspondences. So at that time, manager plays a role as a liaison. So we saw that under the main heading of interpersonal role, manager has to perform the role as a figurehead, as a leader, and as a liaison. The second category of role given by Mintzberg is informational role. Now, under this main heading of informational role, again there are sub roles which are performed by the manager. Under the second role of informational role, manager has to do the sub roles like as a monitor, as a disseminator, and as a spokesperson. These are the three types of roles which manager has to perform under the category of informational role. Now, when we are looking at a manager who has to perform the informational role, that time manager need to be send lot of kind of information to other members of the society. So while transmitting the information, while giving the information, while communicating the information, he has to play a role of a monitor, he has to play a role of a spokesperson, he has to play the role of a disseminator. Now, when manager plays a role of monitor, he seeks and receives wide variety of special information to develop a thorough understanding of the organization and environment. Emerges as now center of internal and external information of the organization. He need to seek and receive lot of information from other resources, which will be helpful for thorough understanding and environment of the organization. Like, he needs to collect the information from the students, from the teachers, from the staff, from the parents, as well as from the society. So that time he is playing a role of a monitor. He is the one who is monitoring, he is the one who is seeking and collecting information for the development of his organization. Now, while seeking the information, he needs to be in touch of various members of the society from whom he has to collect the information. Like, he has to collect the information from the parents regarding their feedback about the school. He has to collect the information from the teacher regarding the performance of the student, regarding their difficulties, regarding their issues. He has to collect information from teaching and non-teaching staff regarding their feedback about the functioning of the organization. And also at the same time, he needs to collect information from the society. Now, when we are talking about society, there are various members which may not be part of your school, which may not be part of your organization, but still directly or indirectly, they will have an influence on your organization. So from society as well, he needs to collect a lot of information. He has to take the feedback from the society about his or her school. After getting the feedback, he may think of improvement, how he can improve his organization. So the information which he or she gets from the society will help for further development of the organization, and which will help the manager for thorough understanding of the organization. What are the loopholes? What are the weaknesses? Where we need to improve? All this kind of information he will be getting, which will be helping for the betterment of the organization. So while performing this role, he is acting as a monitor. He is the one who is collecting the information, disseminating the information, and using that information for the development of the organization as well as for the development of the environment of the organization. Now, while performing this role as a monitor, what are the activities expected from the manager? He has to acknowledge the mails, he has to respond to the mails, he has to analyze the data which has been collected from the society, from the members of the organization, and from the students as well. And after analyzing the data, he needs to communicate his members so that certain steps can be taken. So basically, while performing a role of manager, what manager is doing? He is collecting the information, analyzing the information, and using the information for betterment of his organization. So by this particular kind of ways through which he collects the information, that need to be analyzed and that need to be used for further actions to be taken. Now, under this main heading of informational role, second sub role the manager is expected to play is disseminator. He has to play the role as a disseminator. Now, when the manager is under the role of disseminator, what he does, whatever information he has collected from the society, that he need to disseminate among the members of the school. Say for example, when the manager get the information from the society, get the information from other head of the schools, so that information need to be disseminated among the members, among the teaching staff, among the non-teaching staff, and even among the student. What we need to do, where we are lacking, what steps we need to take, that he will be informing. So while working as monitor, he collects the information, and that information he is disseminating. That time he is performing the role as a disseminator. He is disseminating that information among the members of the organization, so that the members will be taking some action on it, and they will be finding out some strategy to overcome those particular problems which the organization might be facing. So that time manager is working as a disseminator. He is disseminating that particular information among the members of the organization. Now, while performing a job as a disseminator, he has to send the information. He may send by conducting personal discussions, or those information might be disseminated by mail, via mail, or by conducting a meeting. So these are various activities which is expected when the manager is performing the role as a disseminator. It may happen that manager may conduct a formal meeting, and in that particular meeting he will convey the staff members whatever information he has got from the society, whatever information he has got from the government, and how this information need to be utilized, how what kind of actions need to be taken, what strategies need to be planned. All these things will be discussed under the meeting which is conducted by the manager. Or he can send that particular information, disseminate this particular information via mail, or sometimes some kind of information might also be disseminated by posting. Say for example, if the manager has got any kind of GR from the government, and when the government is asking for response on that particular GR or feedback on that particular GR, then that time manager either mail government authorities, or manager has to do the correspondence by posting the feedback. So in this way, these are the various activities which the manager has to do while performing a role as a disseminator. The activities like conducting a meeting, answering the mail, or corresponding the feedback, these are some of the activities which the manager may be involved while performing a role as a disseminator. Now, under the second role, that is informational role, the third subcategory is spokesperson. The manager also has to transmit the information to the society. For example, the manager will convey the society, convey the parents what are their policies, what are their results, what are their achievements throughout the year. Because unless and until this information is sent to the society, it will not help in establishing the rapport with the society, and other people from the society will not come to know about the status of that particular organization. So, manager, while performing a role as a spokesperson, he disseminates the information to the society, and this information will be their achievements, their strengths, whatever they have done in this particular year, what are their enrollment, how many students of class standard 10th has been passed, what are their results. This information need to be disseminated to the society. And when manager transmits this information to the society, that time he is playing the role as a spokesperson. He is a spokesperson who is representing his institute, and he is the spokesperson who is giving the information, transmitting the information about the schools or organizations' achievements, their results, and what are their status in the society. So how this will help him? It will help for the betterment of the organization, because unless and until the society knows about your progress, they will not be sending their student to the organization, to the school. So this information need to be transmitted to the society if we want to survive in the society, because unless and until the parents, the society knows the status of the school, they are not going to enroll their students in that particular school. So school's progress, school's development, what are their future plans, what are their policies in the coming year also needs to be communicated to the society. So while doing so, manager plays a role as a spokesperson. So while performing the role as a spokesperson, some of the intentional activities which the manager has to be involved are like conducting the board meetings, responding to the mails through annual day, telling the parents about their overall performance over the year, what are their future plans, what are their policies. These things can be communicated to the parents by way of annual day celebration, by way of mailing, by way of publishing their prospectus, wherein parents will come to know what are their strengths and what are their achievements in the whole year. So in this way, some of the activities which the manager is expected to involve, which is very much required for transmitting the information to the society. So under the broad category of informational role, we saw that manager plays a role as a monitor, manager plays the role as a leader, and manager plays the role as a disseminator. So under the second subcategory, that is informational role, manager has to play the role like monitor, disseminator and spokesperson. Now let us come to the third category of the role played by the manager. The third category of the role played by the manager is decisional role. While functioning in the organization, manager has to take one or the other decisions. It may not happen that manager has not to take any decisions. Decision may be related to day-to-day working, like which teacher will be going to which class, allotting the timetable, then student-related problems, answering the government GRs. If there is any change, any decisions taken by the government, what needs to be taken. So starting from student-related problem to taking decisions related with the government, manager has to take one or the other decisions. So while performing this role as a decisional role, manager has to work as a entrepreneur, as a change agent. Many times manager has to take various decisions which is very much required for further development of that organization. So that time manager is performing a role as an entrepreneur, or we can say as a change agent. Second role performed by the manager is disturbance handler, resource allocator and negotiator. So while performing the role as a decisional role, manager has to play the role as entrepreneur, as a disturbance handler, as a negotiator and as a resource allocator. Now let us see what these roles means to him. When manager plays a role as an entrepreneur, he is actually acting as a change agent. Manager has to take decision for future development of his organization. It may be simple decision like next year they want to start with another medium. It may be decision related that they want to start another board, like say for example, now they are offering SSC board and they are planning to start CBSE board in the school. So what are the changes required? What needs to be done? Whom to contact? How the syllabus need to be framed? All these decisions need to be taken by the manager. So that time manager is working as a change agent or a entrepreneur. Entrepreneur is the one who is the risk takers, who will be finding out the innovative ideas for the development of the organization. So manager, while performing a role of decisional role, he is acting as an entrepreneur, he is acting as a change agent. Manager, while performing the role as an entrepreneur, he is actually acting as a change agent. So when he is playing the role as a change agent or an entrepreneur, first he need to supervise the things, he need to identify the things and he need to do the planning for development. So that time manager is working as an entrepreneur. No manager will be satisfied what is happening in this. No one would like, they also want to remain at the same position, at the same level after 5 years or 10 years. everybody want to progress, everybody want to think of their progress, because as the scenario changes, as the situation changes, demands of the society changes, so it is bound to happen that you also need to change. If you don't change, you are not going to survive in the society. So manager, while performing a role as an entrepreneur, as a change agent, needs to identify what are the demands of the society, what are the needs of the society, is there any change expected in the curriculum, what are the skills expected to develop among students, how they can think of doing all-round development of the students. All these things need to be think of well in advance, so that after 5 years or 10 years they will be surviving in the competition. So that time manager is playing as a role of a entrepreneur. Entrepreneur is the one who always seeks the opportunity, take advantage of that opportunity, and always strive to do better for the organization. Same way, when manager is in the role of an entrepreneur, he need to seek the opportunities wherein he can perform better. He need to grab the opportunity, he need to collect the funds from the society and use it for the development of the organization. So that time manager is playing the role as a entrepreneur. So let us see what are the various activities expected when my manager is performing the role as a entrepreneur. The first and foremost thing is he need to supervise the whole organization. He need to find out various schemes. He need to find out various policies which may be for the betterment of the organization. So first and foremost, he need to be very much alert. He need to find out the various provisions done by the government. What are the new schemes which is upcoming and which will be useful for his school, and what are the various government regulations that also need to be taken care. So all these things he need to think of when he is performing the role as a entrepreneur. Manager, while taking the decision for the betterment of the organization, he also many times need to be take decisions which may happen suddenly in the organization. Say for example, there might some situation occur in the organization for which it is expected that manager should take immediate action over it. So that time he is working as a disturbance handler, or we can call it as a conflict manager. Many times it may happen that certain unexpected situation may happen in the organization. Say for example, simple example we can take, there is some accidents occur in the school, some of the boy fell down from the staircase. So at that time immediately manager need to take some actions like calling the parents, taking the child for first aid help. So these are the things which suddenly happens, which suddenly occurs in the organization. For that also manager needs to be ready. So that time he is playing a role as a disturbance handler. It may happen that suddenly there is a dispute between or quarrel between teaching and non-teaching staff. So then at that time, after realizing that there is some dispute or there is some quarrel between teaching and non-teaching staff, it is expected that the manager should intervene and resolve the issue. So while playing a role as a conflict manager or as a disturbance handler, many times manager has to take decisions for resolving the conflict, for handling the situation, or for maintaining peace in the organization. So that time manager is playing the role as a conflict manager or a disturbance handler. So that it is very much important to handle the disturbance properly. It is very much important to handle the conflict effectively in order to smooth functioning of the organization. So when the manager is in the role of disturbance handler or conflict manager, he has to involve in activities like giving memos. If the manager finds that certain person is faulty and he is the one who has created disturbance, he is the one who has created problem in the organization, so that person should be given the memo reporting the higher authorities. Say for example, HM is the manager of the school. So if any certain issue occurs, say for example, teachers has gone for the strike. So in that particular situation, manager himself may not take a decision. He has to consult higher authorities. The higher authorities might be the top level management or the management people or people in the board whom need to be consulted, and how to tackle this particular issue, how to resolve the conflict. So in that particular situation, he may consult the top management and take the decision. So that time he is involved in consulting the top management. He may involved in taking decisions, which is very much important in day-to-day functioning of the organization. These are some of the activities wherein the manager is expected to involve while taking the decisions. While performing the decisional role, manager also has to play the role as a resource allocator. How to allocate the resource, how to distribute the resource, how to divide the resources for the betterment of the organization. That decision also manager has to take. Say for example, certain amount of budget is kept for developing the teaching learning material, certain amount of budget is kept for sending the teachers for their professional development courses, certain amount of budget need to be kept for professional training of the teachers. So how to allocate those budgets, how to allocate the budget for maintenance of furniture, how to allocate budget for day-to-day functioning of the organization, that also manager has to take. So financial management, human resource management and other resource management also manager has to think of how to manage those particular resources. When you are functioning in the organizations, manager has to allocate financial resources, human resources and infrastructural resources. If there is shortage of classroom, then how to make available to the classroom, whether to run two shifts in the school or whether to run only one shift in the school, that decision also manager has to take. If there is only one computer lab in a school, then which class will be going, in what time this particular room will be available to which class and all, that also manager has to think in advance. So manager is working as a resource allocator. While allocating the resources, again he has to take lot of decision. How much budget for the maintenance, how much budget to be kept for the development of the organization, how much budget to be kept for the training of the teachers, all needs to be think by the manager. So this is about financial management. Same way human resource management, how many teaching staff is available, if there is any shortage of teaching staff, do we need to appoint some more teaching staff or do we need to increase the workload of the teachers, that decision also need to be taken care by the manager. So human resource management, financial management and infrastructure management, all these decisions has to be taken which is related to the resource allocation. So while performing the role of decisional role, manager also sometimes may has to act as a resource allocator. He need to divide the resources so that there will be smooth functioning of the organization. Like he has to involve in activities like scheduling. Like it may happen that you may have lack of resources, so you need to decide which room will be available to which classroom. If there is only one seminar room or only one conference room, so how to make arrangement of the programs so that everybody will get a chance to use that particular conference room. So that scheduling need to be done, and this is done by the manager when he is performing as a resource allocator. Scheduling, budgeting and allotting resources, these are some of the activities which is expected when the manager is playing the role as a resource allocator. Now the fourth role performed by the manager under the category of decisional role is as a negotiator. Manager has to negotiate lot of things with the teachers, with the parents, with the students and with the society. So that time again he has to take a decision. Say for example, let us take the same example. If suddenly there has some teachers has gone on the strike, then it is expected that in that particular period of strike, manager has to play the role as a negotiator. So that time he may be playing the role as a negotiator who will be communicating to the teachers what management is ready to listen to them. What are the demands of the teacher that need to be communicated to the management. So that time he is playing a role as a negotiator. Negotiator is the one who finds out the solution for both the parties. How the teachers will also be satisfied and how the management will also be happy. So that manager is playing a role of negotiator. He is negotiating with the teacher and whatever demands the teacher is putting, that he is forwarding to the management. So he has to play a role of negotiator as well, and that time he has to take a lot of decisions. So under the category of decisional role, manager also has to play a role as a negotiator. He will be a negotiator between management and the teacher. He has to negotiate with the parents, with the community, with the children. A lot of things need to be negotiated. That time he plays a role as a negotiator. While negotiating with the parents, say for example, parents are not happy with the hike in fees. So that time manager need to be negotiate with the parents. For what purpose they are asking for that much increase in fees, how these fees will be utilized for the development of their infrastructure, for the development of the building, for the welfare of their school. So that need to be convinced to the parents. So that time he will be playing the role as a negotiator. He will be the link between parent and the organization. Sometimes manager also need to negotiate with the students. What are their problems? How these problems can be tackled? At that time he need to take certain decisions. Say for example, if any student have a lot of problem at home and he or she is not able to come to the school, so at that time what provisions can be done, how other student can help them out, so that decision need to be taken. How much concession should be given to the student, that also need to be taken by the manager. So he has to negotiate with the parents, with the teacher, with the union, and also with the students. So that time he has to find out the better way which will be helping both the parties and which will be helping both the parties and keeping them satisfied. So that time he plays a role as a negotiator. Now while playing the role as a negotiator, he may need to conduct lot of meeting with the parents, meeting with the teacher, meeting with the students, and also meeting with the unions. So he may be involved in activities like conducting the meetings, answering them, getting their feedback, and communicating this feedback to the top level management. So he plays a role as a negotiator. So in this way we saw that while playing a decisional role, manager acts as an entrepreneur, manager acts as a disturbance handler, manager acts as a negotiator, and also manager acts as a resource allocator. So under the category of decisional role, manager performs sub roles like entrepreneur, disturbance handler, resource allocator, and negotiator. These are the four sub roles manager are expected to play while playing the decisional role.